the youth and the public will lose respect for all the scholars, and they would then lose respect for the deen. They would not be interested in listening to the scholars, saying these guys are just fighting amongst each other. Each one is calling the other names. No, no, each one is not calling the other names. Some are calling others' names while the others are busy working very hard. I was taught by my own scholars and my own asatida, my teachers and those whom we look up to in terms of our elders, our predecessors. They always said, busy yourself in your work. Never insult a person you differ with. What's your aim? Is it to present the haq and the truth? If it is, present it in the most beautiful way. Say, I believe this opinion is correct because of A, B, and C. And I believe this opinion is totally wrong. It is unacceptable because of X, Y, and Z. Stop there and continue. But when you begin to belittle someone, call them names, remember, you are far away from Islam, let alone the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Because the Prophet ﷺ says, لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال حبة من خردل من كبر. A person in whose heart is an iota or a mustard seed's weight worth of pride will not enter paradise. So the Sahaba radiallahu anhum asked him, you know, we like to wear good clothes, good shoes, etc., conveyance, whatnot. He said, no, the pride is to reject the truth and to despise people, to belittle others. That is pride. Pride comes in three most important things. Number one, when you have a lot of wealth, you need to check yourself for pride. Number two, when you have a lot of authority, you need to check yourself for pride. Number three, when you have a lot of wealth, you need to check yourself for pride. These three things are an amana for the ummah, not for you. When Allah gives you wealth, it's not for you, it's for the ummah. When Allah gives you authority, it's not for you, it's for the ummah. When Allah gives you knowledge, it's not for you, it's for the ummah. So Allah tests you and shaitan comes and tamper with you. You develop pride. I think I know. I think I have. I think I'm powerful. The minute those three contaminate your mind, you have a problem. You need to go to a real and a true scholar of the deen just to clean your heart. Today, we have sheikhs who people look up to and they say, this is my sheikh. But if you study that sheikh, he has hatred in him. He has jealousy. He has ill feeling. He swears and belittles other scholars. What type of a sheikh is it? Is it not a sign of the hour? A simple vagabond from the street will tell you, please clean your heart. La ilaha illallah.